Ministry of Education is attempting to mobilize local businesses within the scientific community to partner with it in the execution of a sub-regional microscience experiments project. The project, which will first be introduced through a pilot to one secondary school in each of the 8 educational districts, seeks to promote capacity building for science education. Minister for Education, Human Resource Development and Labor, Honorable Robert Lewis, who spoke at a recent workshop to commence the pilot, says the initiative will eventually be introduced fully to all secondary schools on the island and subsequently to primary and tertiary institutions.
To this end, we have called upon business community partners who are actively engaged with science to assist in popularizing this program. I would like to take this opportunity to express profound gratitude to the St. Lucia Electricity Services Limited and Harris Pint Limited for unreservedly accepting to partner with us in this important initiative. We trust that many others will come on board to support this project.
The initiative is funded under the UNESCO Global Microscience Experiments Project and is being managed by the St. Lucia Commission on UNESCO. Minister with responsibility for science and technology, Senator the Honorable James Fletcher, has thrown his support behind the project, which will provide schools with the ability to conduct practical work in science in areas where limited or no laboratory facilities are available.
It doesn't matter what you plan on doing later on in life. Once you have a science background, once you have a very solid science foundation, you could basically transition into any field, be it law, be it medicine, engineering. If you want to become a poet later on in life, you could do that. It doesn't matter. Once you have a science foundation, you can. You can't say the same for other disciplines, because I dare say there are not very many other disciplines that not having had a science foundation can go into science afterwards.
The microscience method provides new teaching tools which contribute to capacity building, even in areas where no laboratory facilities are available. From the Communications Unit of the Ministry of Education, Human Resource Development and Labor, this is Chris Satney reporting.